Hey guys, it's Saul again. I know it's been a long while since I uploaded, like about a week or two back. Yeah, I was very, very mad at Brave Frontier. I'm still playing it, but I'm not gonna be summoning any more in that game, not after how much BS I've been put through. But this isn't about Brave Frontier today. Yes, you're seeing footage from a PS4. My PS4. That's right. For Christmas this year, I got a PS4 Pro for Christmas. And not only that, but this. Sorry about that. It's Final Fantasy 15 Day 1 Edition. So if you can't see it well, blame the camera and the lighting for why my bulbs is stupid. Anywho, today I am bringing you a video to tell you how to gain in every trophy within the Ratchet and Clank game for the PS4. Now, this is gonna contain some spoiler warnings, so if you don't want to be spoiled on this video, then avoid it and come back to it when you're about near the end of the game. Now, let's get started. Now, as you can see, I'm 97% done. The only trophy left to get in the game is the Heroes of Heroes trophy, which is... I have to get the Challenging trophy, which I'm about to get, and the other one is Hero of Heroes. Now, let's get started. End of the beginning. Now, this is the spoiler for the final boss. Defeat Dr. Nefarious under the Planetizer, which is the last area you have to go to. Ooh. He is a very, very simple boss if you're using the Rhino Extreme, which is the strongest weapon in the game. Now, getting the Rhino Extreme is, well, there are about 9 different areas. Two of the first cards can be found on planet Rilgar. Alright, for one. Well, I'll go through it soon, but still. No. Beating Nefarious is very simple. Super Trader. There are a total of 33 different holo cards. My tips for you is wherever duplicates you get, and if you have any sets that are about one away from being fully complete, use that. Now, and real quick, for the Rhino cards, you have to find the cards simply by exploring and doing a couple trespasser puzzles. Unfortunately, you will not be able to get to trade in any duplicates for a Rhino card. So, yeah. That sucks. However, there are a total of 33 holo card sets. But, there is a 34th holo card set, but this is only available if you got the prior bonus of getting the bouncer weapon. And now, I don't believe this has to be included for the completion of the game. So, you don't really need to get the heavy bouncer, weapon, just complete the game 100%. Challenging, simple, beat the whole entire game on challenge mode, which is your second run through of the game. Ultimate Explorer. Now, describing every bolt location would be tough. However, you'll be able to know how many bolts are in a certain planet you're in, simply by a being in the ship. Yep. Now, you will gain one item at the very end of the game known as the Map-O-Matic. Getting that item, it's at the very close end of the game, like the second to last planet, and right before you visit the ED Planetizer for the second time. There are 28 gold bolts in total, and getting each one's is quite simple in all honesty. So you won't have a hard time if you explore well. Now, But if you're having a hard time, wait until you're at the end of the game when you get the map-o-matic, which is on Kalibo 3 by doing the grind rail section. Action. Now, onwards. Full gun rack. Acquire every weapon in the game. Now, again, you don't have to get the heavy balancer pre-order bonus from GameStop just to gain this trophy. Full gun rack is, though, kind of tricky because you're going to have to save up your bolts a lot. And possibly the very last weapon you'll acquire in the game is the Rhino. There is one last Rhino Holo card, and it is before the last two final bosses. Yes, there are two final bosses at the end of this game. There's only a total of four bosses in the game, and yet, well, they can all be pathetically easy if you're using the Rhino. Of course, on your first playthrough, you will not have the Rhino until the end of the game. Now, Master of War. Here's my tip. Upgrade every gun to level 5 at level 5 for your first run through of the game. This way they're ready for challenge mode. And that everything's very simple for you. Yeah, those are my tips for you. Now, about grinding. You don't have to necessarily just go back and forth and dying in certain places. No. Basically, I suggest only going back and forth between a random planet and mainly the deplanetizer. Grind from the deplanetizer the most. This way, your weapons will level up fast, especially the Rhino Extreme, which is the strongest form of the Rhino. And here's the thing about leveling up the weapons. Happens that will probably entice you a little bit. They'll level up based on how much damage you're dealing with the weapon. Yeah, that's how the experience system is working with the game. Now let's keep going. These go to 11. Unlock every modification for every weapon. Now in your first run through of the game, you will not be able to gain every single modification for your weapon actually. Even if you supposedly 100% all of the, mod Veritanium maps for each of the weapons, because the Omega mods actually unlock a little bit more upgrades for your weapon, making them even more stronger than normal. Not only by leveling up, but by simply increasing, giving you more little places to use your Veritanium for. And don't worry, for challenge mode, you'll gain even more Raritanium than normal. There's at least two places, I think, where you'll be able to gain about 10 Raritanium at once. One is on Gaspar, in which if you get all 60 brains, or the total amount is actually 90 brains, but you'll be able to have the map Apple-Mac for your second playthrough. If I remember correctly, for Gaspar, you gain three different rewards. First rewards by collecting 10 brains, means you'll be able to get the jetpack. Now, if you collect 20 brains next for the scientist guy, he'll give you an info bond for another planet. Totaling up to 30 brains, by the way. Now, the last one is getting 60 brains, and this will involve you exploring quite a lot. So keep your eyes peeled on Gaspar. Now, the last reward you'll get is the Bolt Basher, or the Box Basher, But the Box Basher will include, the ability to break boxes from a good distance, plus increases the range of Bolt Magnetism. Mainly, it's like a treasure magnet from the Kingdom Hearts series. Anyways, Mr. Fancy Pants. Upgrade Ratchet's health to maximum level. His maximum health is 200. At the end of my first playthrough of the game, I had 130 health. Yeah, I was grinding for a long time to just get my weapons to level 5, so let's keep going. Every gadget, you'll acquire every gadget as the game naturally progresses. So, you don't have to worry too much there. Abby Normal. Like I said, collect all 90 telepathopus brains on Gaspar. Go Speed Ratchet, go. Win the Gold Cup on both Rilgar and Kalibo. Now, there is a Hoverboard Challenge on Kalibo and Rilgar. Rilgar, you'll encounter that first. Now, for Rilgar and Kalibo, they'll have a Bronze Cup race, a Silver Cup race, and a Gold Cup race. And as you can guess, right, the difficulty goes up on each. But there are separate trophies for Rilgar and Kalibo, which I'll get to soon. Safecracker. Make sure for every trespasser puzzle you do, do not use auto hack. Else, well, you're basically fucking yourself over for your first playthrough. Yeah. But don't worry. Don't worry. You'll be able to get this weapon. You'll be able to get this weapon. You'll be able to do every trespasser puzzle if you look well enough. Sorry if I'm taking too long here. I'll try and speed things along a little bit better here. So, yeah, there are 16 trespasser puzzles in total. So, make sure you do not use the auto hack feature, else you will not get this trophy at the end of the game. Because the last little trespasser puzzle is right before the third boss of the game, part of the final boss. Maximizing potential. Now, this is when you're on, well, let me think here. Your challenge mode playthrough, and just get any weapon at level 10, and then, bam, you get this trophy. The first weapon I upgraded was the Peacemaker. Yeah, I was able to get that weapon up very fast due to the high amount of damage. Basically training. Complete the Ranger tryouts on Veldin. Now, these trophies are basically story progression. Action trophies you'll naturally get. The little robot that could, the rescuer, off to the races. You're in the Rangers now, winner, winner, Sand Shark dinner. This is for being the Bronze Cup on Rilgar, which is required for the story. Oi, I believe. Eve. Defeat the Snaggle Beast, which is being the first boss of the game. Aim.
Who's a good Snaggle Beast?
Brains. Collect 30 brains for the scientist and Gaspar. Yeah, another story mission you have to do right there. I shut down your battleship. Shoot down the Blarg battleships on Batalia. Zircon Family Values. This is for being the second boss of the game, which is Mrs. Zircon on Quartu. Ooh. And real quick, she's an easy boss to beat if you, well, been leveling up your pixelizer quite a lot. So, being her should be a cinch for you. Ooh, right there, if you level up the, well, like I said, the Pixelizer HD. If you have it at level 5. Snaggle Beast, he's kind of hard to beat. He just watches patterns, and whenever he does a ground pound and whatnot, make sure you're not standing under a rising fire geyser. Lava geyser. I don't even know. Oh, but yeah. He'll also summon enemies, but if you have, like, the Zircon with you, you should be fine. Just make sure you're moving often. Don't land in the lava. Splashdown. Shoot down the Hydro Harvesters on Pocataru. Ferocious Oxide. Defeat Victor in the Phoenix. Now, the Phoenix isn't a planet you travel to. This is another story progression mission. And you have to defeat Victor Von Ion on here. And this requires Clank to go through two puzzles, which can be kind of confusing. So if you're having a difficult time, make sure you just do one little thing. Aim for yourself. Just freaking it. Hold up. Defeat Victor Von Ion, the Phoenix, so... Yeah, just look up a guide if you're confused. Radical. Oh, this is for winning in the Hoverboard Bronze Cup on Kalibo. Evo. So, yeah. Just win the Bronze Cup on Kalibo. a change of heart to free Cork on the Planetizer. He is the third boss of the game, and yes, you do face him. It was part of the original game that you do face him, in all honesty. And as game goes, yeah, he is the third boss right there. Faster than the speeding amoeboid. Oh lordy, this trophy. I'm gonna be quick with you here. Getting Kalibal Thunder is easier than getting the faster than the speeding amoeboid. Now, of what I did figure out, if you've, well, basically, let me think. If you have all 20 gold bolts, you'll be able to unlock a cheat that allows you to not take any damage. But for challenge mode, even with invincibility on, you'll lose the bolt multiplier when you get hit. Just to let you know. But if you have the invincibility cheaper, faster than a speeding amoeboid, you'll make things easier on yourself. And this is something I did figure out in my challenge mode playthrough. However, the thing is, I did this without even knowing about that invincibility will not slow you down when you hit something. So yeah. Oh yeah, and also for this trophy right here, you have to do it in the gold cup. Same thing with Kalibal Thunder. You have to beat the gold cup in Railgar in a minute and 35. For Kalibal Thunder, you have to beat the gold cup in Kalibo in 2 minutes 5 seconds, which there are at least two shortcuts you can take to at least get you to the goal even faster for each lap. So you'll possibly finish that one up in quite a few seconds, in all honesty. So yeah, Kalibal Thunder is easier than faster than a speeding amoeboid. But if you want to give yourself a challenge for faster than a speeding amoeboid, then try and get the trophy without using the cheat of invincibility, like how I did it, and yeah, I never knew that. Yeah, it was frustration for that. Kirwan Gladiator. You have to complete the fitness course in Kirwan you do this at the start for a story progression, but if you do this in under 70 seconds, you get this trophy. Yeah, it is tricky for the first two islands, so make sure on the second one, though, you're careful with what you do. That's what I'm just saying. Clank Crusher. This is an easy one. During Clank's puzzle section here, just crush 5 Gadgetbots in the Crusher on Quartu. During the second puzzle he has to do, I believe, that involves all the conveyor belts. It's a lot easier than you think, Ink. Now, the conveyor Clank is referring to, by the way, during this section, and it's the one that's going to make a loop around these electric generators that a Chargerbot would charge up to activate. So, yeah, that's how you can do the Clank Crusher. That sinking feeling. All you gotta do is knock a Constructobot into the quickstand on Iridia. Easiest thing is, when you're coming up onto these little conveyor belts, of when you enter the sports shack and take the right route. And not the left route that involves the swing shots. A jump strike just to knock them into that. And bam, you get it. I hate lamp. Break every lamp in the Lero City. The locations of these lamps are kinda something. Oh. One thing. In the Lero City, when you get to the train station, there will be a few lamps that are far off across the train tracks. The train station, I meant. And you'll have to probably get the Plasma Striker just to hit those. Or if you're lucky enough, you can hit it from afar. But it depends on the range of whatever weapon you're using for that. And I suggest searching up a guide, or at least going up onto my YouTube channel and search out my guide section, where I often add and other YouTubers' guide videos onto that playlist. And hey, this helps them out because if you see them, you could probably subscribe to those people, able to get some tips and tricks on how to get these trophies. Not my job. This is easy. Just let the Extermabots kill 35 Amiiboids in Rilgar. It's very, very simple for you right there. Top Gunner. On Gaspar, when you have the jetpack, just kill 40 enemies while in the air. That's it. Make sure you're not on the ground, though. When sheep fly, turn a Blarg helicopter into a sheep. You'll get the sheep in air on Kalibo 3, which is one of the best weapons besides Rhino. So yeah, you'll gain a sheep in air, which can yield more Raritanium if you invested into that. This is a trophy you can probably get on your on one of your first two playthroughs, actually. For challenge mode or for your first one. Warbots and the Plowshares. Destroy 10 inactive warbots inside a Core 2 factory. This is easy. The robots that are coming out on the conveyor belts, just shoot them up with a weapon, like maybe the Peacemaker / Warmonger. Pool Sharks are the worst. Yeah, this is basically get eaten by a pool shark in the Poketaru Sea. In which, just swim out far enough where you see these big fish, they'll come after you and instantly kill you. Yeah, it's a trophy, alright. Ridiculous? Yes, I know. Kyoto Assassination. Just destroy the plant and it models in Drek's office when you're on your first or second trip to the deplanetizer. By the way, there is a switch in his office to get to a gold bolt. You'll just hit it with a magma buster shot. And then it'll drop down a ladder for you to climb, and then you'll be able to get to that gold bolt. There's a second gold bolt in a statue room with two statue Dreks, but you'll need Clank just to get to it. It to Copernicus? Yes. Find Quark's Lounge on the deplanetizer. This is a misleading one. You don't have to necessarily find a location. It's near the hangar room you're heading to on your second trip when you have the hollow guys on. So turn on the hollow guys there. On one of the routes there, there should be a door leaning downwards and a door right next to it on the left side. Alright. Just wave in the door, wait a couple of moments, and then you'll hear Quark say something. And then you get this trophy. Lazy Lombax, you just have to ride four different conveyor or catwalks on Kalibo. One of them is when you're coming up nearing the end of the area. When you're getting close to the end, just ride it without moving, and then you'll get the trophy. There are three other catwalks, which is right by your ship, so getting those should be easy. Death by Disco, just use the Groovitron on every enemy you come across. If you run out of ammo, go and restock. Locked by spending your bolts. Trader in Training, just complete your first holocard set. Very easy. Modder, complete your first Raritanium mod. You'll be able to get that during the start of the game. Cha-ching, you'll need to gain the 20 bolt multiplier. Best place to go to is Batalia. For that. And if you're trying to go to another planet for that, mostly Batalia is the best. This way, the enemies are either one-shot. And you won't die so easily there. But make sure your platforming's good and that you don't fall to an instant death. Trade up. Trade in a set of duplicate cards for a new one for the first time. And that's every trophy except for challenging. So, yeah, that's actually everything. Being right there. So all I gotta do is challenging, then I get the Hero of Heroes. Which is being the game in challenge mode. So, that's it. I'll just upload this video right now, just so I don't waste anyone's time any further. Oh, and one little thing. Recently, Yes, I was wearing socks. Do you have a problem with it? I got this. World of Final Fantasy, the limited edition. Now, what the limited edition comes with is an art book, which is the case itself. And you'll be able to get a Lilkin and Sephiroth summon, White Chocobo, Glow Moogle, and Red Donneth Berry, a monster to have with you for the game. This is gonna be a new game I'm gonna try, so should be fun. Now, one last thing before I go. For one, yes, I shaved the beard, because that's what my New Year's resolution there. Start right the year off with a fresh face. Another thing, I'll try not to upload old summon videos again, because I'm not honestly gonna record myself ever again uploading a video where I just go into an outburst. Yeah, I'm sorry to anyone and who may have gotten offended by that, but I wasn't happy at the time. I did a total of 33 pulls for Zeruia, and it was just unbearable for me. So again, and I'll try to refrain from uploading videos like that ever again, and just upload different content for Brave Frontier. Here. For Brave Frontier though, I did get a few units at least from trying to summon Zeruia. Got my first Alara finally. I got Rayla from it. I think I got Zekt from it, so that it, I think. Yeah, there were a few units that I was able to pull. By the way, the Toy Hado unit, it's a good one. It's decent, but it's not the best. Yes, I suggest you go watch Ushi's videos to learn more about it. But anyways, I gotta go. So, until another day where I upload another video. Ciao.